In the previous movie, we set up a no-flip knee ideal for walk and run cycles. In this movie, we'll alter it into a dual knee solution for greater versatility. Start by opening the file Character Rigging, Part 15 Start, or by using your own file from the previous lesson. Our current scene uses a no-flip setup along with a custom attribute to control the knee's orientation. While this is great to avoid leg flips due to the foot control moving past the knee locator, aiming the knee with a custom attribute may not be the most intuitive method for the animator. For these scenarios, we'd like to bring back our original pull vector solution, where we could aim the knee using a control in the workspace. However, we'd like to do this without losing all the advantages of our easy-to-use no-flip knee. The solution is to set up both types of knees, then create a switch allowing animators to choose whether they want a no-flip knee or an aimable pole vector knee. To make this possible, we'll combine a few of the different rigging techniques we've learned so far. Just like we're using an FK joint chain and an IK joint chain to drive the result joints, we can actually create two sets of joints to drive the IK leg as well. Then we'll create a blend attribute on our left leg settings control to switch between them, exactly as we did with the IK-FK switching in part 11 of this series. Note that this dual knee setup will be independent of the foot rig, which we'll build in upcoming movies. First, we'll want to duplicate the existing IK leg twice to set up our no-flip knee and pole vector knee. However, if we did this using the duplicate command, we'd have to rebuild our two knee solutions from scratch. Instead, select the entire IK leg and foot control and perform a duplicate special operation. Reset the settings, then make sure to turn the duplicate input graph on. This duplicates all your joints plus their connections to the other objects we selected, such as IK handles and the knee locator. Now let's clean this up a little bit. Under the original IK foot control, we'll need to delete left leg handle and left leg IK length end log, since this is now just a generic leg that will be driven by our two knee solutions. We'll also delete the no-flip knee group for this generic IK leg, as well as any remaining length measurement locators. We'll leave the IK handles controlling the foot's ball and toe, as both knee solutions will drive the same foot rig. Now rename the new duplicated joints and their leg IK handle, effector, knee, pole vector constraint, and length nodes with the identifier no flip. Parent the left leg no-flip handle, length end loc, and no-flip knee group under the generic IK foot control. Then delete the duplicated left foot control, as well as the left ball and toe joints. Remember, our no-flip leg is only a knee solution and has no bearing on the foot. We'll also need to use the connection editor to hook up the left foot control's knee twist attribute to the no-flip knee group's rotate Y attribute, since we deleted the old one. Now that we have our generic IK leg and no-flip leg set up, duplicate the no-flip leg, its IK handle, length locators, and knee group one more time with the duplicate special command. As you may have guessed, we'll rename all these nodes with PV for our pole vector knee. And as before, we'll reparent the IK handle, length end locator, and knee group to the generalized IK foot control, then delete the extra duplicated foot control and IK joints. However, for the pole vector knee, we'll unparent the knee control locator from the left foot control. Delete the leftover group since it's empty now. Now we need to return this locator back to its original start position. Select the left leg PV handle and set the twist value back to 0. Then select the left knee PV loc and set its translation to 0. Excellent. Now both knees are set up. You just need to create a blend between them and the generic IK thigh, shin, and foot joints. We're going to skip past that step here, but feel free to consult the scene file linked below, as well as part 11 of this series if you're having trouble. When finished, you should have 6 additional blend color nodes, 3 for rotation and 3 for translation. Now we'll create a new custom attribute to blend between the two knee solutions. Select the left leg settings node and create a new custom attribute. Rather than referring to these as no flip and pole vector solutions, we're going to call them auto and manual knees, to make things simpler for the animator. Name the attribute Auto Manual Knee Blend, then turn on Override Nice Name and use the nice name Auto / Manual Knee Blend. Set minimum to 0 and maximum to 1. Connect it to all the blend color nodes via the connection editor to drive all the blender attributes, just as we did before. Now in auto mode, we can control the knee via the knee twist attribute, while in manual mode, we can control it with the left knee control. You can hide all the IK legs in the workspace. Finally, consider our manual knee control right now. It's just a locator. It would be nice if we could change this over to a NURBS curve, so that if we wanted to hide all the controls in the scene, we could just deactivate the NURBS display. Let's trace this curve from a polygon pyramid, which will be easier to distinguish from our other controls with its pointy shape. Scale the pyramid up and rotate it so it points down the Z-axis. Also, move it in Z so its face falls on the X-axis. Now with the EP curve tool in linear mode, trace a NURBS version. Rename the curve left knee control and point snap it to the same spot as the current left knee PV loc. Freeze its transformations and parent the left knee PV loc under it, then hide it from the workspace. Then add the new control to the legs IK layer. There, this is much nicer to look at. However, one thing stands out. Although we can now aim the knee where we want, we can't plant it as precisely as the other IK controls. In the next movie, we'll add the ability to snap the knee directly to the control.